fortunate to have with us a professor from Tennessee State University, Professor Mohamed Kanu, who is talking about some aspects of President Obama's health plan. And let's see, Dr. Kanu, if you might give us what you might consider to be some of the key elements of Mr. Obama's health plan, and then we'll work from it from that angle.
Okay, absolutely. First, it's important to put this plan in a proper context. What is it about? Mm-hmm. The plan is focused on expanding coverage mm-hmm. and reducing healthcare costs. Mm-hmm. It comes, of course, with a very huge price tag. Mm-hmm. It's always about $76.8 billion mm-hmm. for fiscal year 2010. Now, after knowing that, the second important component of that is a reserve fund. Mm-hmm. This fund is supposed to be there, or is going to be there for a 10-year period. At the range of $360 million. Mm-hmm. This is what is supposed to be used to improve the health of all Americans. Mm-hmm. But in a very succinct way, in a nutshell, mm-hmm. the plan itself has 8 major components. Mm-hmm. And the first component, of course, talks about speeding up the use of electronic records. Mm-hmm. You know, this is very, very important. Mm-hmm. And you know, if I may just spend 1 second mm-hmm. talking about that. Institute for the Future in the United States talks about how important the use of technology has become mm-hmm. when you consider the fact that there's roughly about 33 million hospital admissions in a year mm-hmm. With 505 outpatient visits and 208 billion prescriptions mm-hmm. a year and 408 billion claims. I mean, how do you process all of that information? Mm-hmm. You need to have a system that is going to help improve the efficiency mm-hmm. of handling all of this information. Mm-hmm. So when you hear all of this, it makes sense to you mm-hmm. why the use of technology becomes a very important aspect of this. The second one is an emphasis on improving research, research that will compare the effectiveness or the efficiency of medical treatment. Mm-hmm. And this is underscored by the importance of what is called evidence-based medicine. Mm-hmm. How do you look at two treatments and actually decide which of the two is going to give you better outcomes? Mm-hmm. So again, that's a very key element of this. The third element of this is a doubling of amount of money that is used mm-hmm. on cancer research. Mm-hmm. And the way this is proposed is to inject a significant, I think it's $6 billion mm-hmm. In the budget of the NIH, which is the National Institute of Health, mm-hmm. so mm-hmm. that this research will be expanded mm-hmm. and there are other aspects, or in other words, the fourth aspect of this is the recruitment mm-hmm. of clinicians. And here we're talking about health professionals mm-hmm. Such as dentists, nurses, mm-hmm. and physicians. Now, improving the numbers is just one thing. Mm-hmm. The most important thing is actually the distribution. Because sometimes when you look at these numbers, you know, the numbers are there in a lot of ways. Mm-hmm. But you know, how many of these people, how many of these professionals mm-hmm. are willing to serve in underserved areas, okay. such as rural areas. Mm-hmm. For example, one study that I read, it's kind of dated now, I think it was mm-hmm. published in 1998, talks about having 300, and I think it's 303 physicians mm-hmm. serving in usually a very small radius mm-hmm. of a metro area. Mm-hmm. Out for, here's what I want to say. You have, for every 100,000 mm-hmm. patients in metro area, you have 303 physicians mm-hmm. serving that population. Mm-hmm. When you compare that to rural communities, you have 53 physicians, mm-hmm. only 53, mm-hmm. serving 100,000 mm-hmm. patients. Mm-hmm. So you can see the huge disparity there. It's a distribution mm-hmm. problem. Mm-hmm. So again, one of the key elements mm-hmm. of this plan is to make sure that physicians or mm-hmm. professionals are actually evenly distributed mm-hmm. in the country. There is also the need to improve food services. Okay. In other words, you know, we talk about the FDA, okay. Food and Drug mm-hmm. Administration, mm-hmm. Provide additional funding for them so that the food we eat mm-hmm. can be monitored in a more proper mm-hmm. way. Other aspects of the fifth aspect, I should say, include improving the health of minorities, specifically okay. here we're talking about Indians and Alaska Natives. Mm-hmm. So again, a lot of money is going to be put in including excuse me, in improving health outcomes for this particular population. These are some of the key elements of this particular plan. But the important thing is that as you move along all of these issues that I talked about, what you'll find to be a very serious emphasis is prevention, prevention, prevention. When you talk about research, that's what it is. You actually find out what is it that is working and what is not working, so that instead of us waiting for people to get sick before we try to treat them, let us try to prevent the onset of disease in the first place. Of course, the challenge always is, how do you make a case for prevention? Because when you look at it in actual terms, prevention is a non-event. You know, how do you prove that?
Nobody.
Exactly. You know, how do you prove that it's because of the prevention effort that
cancer.
Exactly.
Yeah,
how do
exactly
you prove that? And so you understand why sometimes it's very difficult to make a case to get additional money for a prevention or intervention programs. I must add that another key element is actually improving the health of children. Early Head Start is it's a very significant aspect of this. And so again, I think it's several billions of dollars are going to be injected in this plan also to improve that. And closely associated with that is also what is called a nurse home visitation program. The focus of that is to have nurses visit homes of especially first mothers. You know, these are people who have not been very well informed about prenatal care and things like that. So once you have nurses visiting their homes, you can actually find or help to provide information that they need so that health outcomes will be improved. Of course, you will ask about, you know, is this going well for everybody? There are those who are already up in arms looking at this particular health program. Or health plan and say, you know, this is a usurpation of, the rights of other smaller firms or other insurance in the system. In other words, people are saying this is going to be a one-payer system, you know, with all of the disadvantages associated with that. Hopefully we'll get a chance to talk about that when
and
we come
back. And of course, that's where we'll make preparations for the second commercial break, but it does seem that the health plan is more than the cost of health insurance.
Yes.
Is that what we think?
Yes.
And of course, let us take this second commercial break, and we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break. The guest is